So in this session, we'll be discussing about the remaining portion of your introduction to IoT. So in this, we'll be discussing about the next part. So in the previous session, we discussed about IoT communication APIs followed with IoT enabling technologies. Okay. So in this session, we'll be discussing about the remaining six IoT levels what we do have, and based upon the requirement, we might be using. So what are the projects we might be creating? Based upon our requirements, we may be using any one of these levels, and based on that, we'll be executing our projects. So the very first, before discussing about these levels, is we should know about the different components what we have related to your IoT. So we already discussed it. One, we have something is device. Next, we have resources. Device is nothing but whatever the physical objects we people are deploying, okay, in an environment, to get the information, to read the information from the environment, and based on that perform certain operations. So that all comes under device. The physical device, what we people are deploying in the environment. Something like, you know, your temperature sensor, humidity sensor, DH, okay, we call it as DHT. Okay, that is nothing but a humidity and temperature sensor. Same way we have accelerometer sensor. Okay, we have gyroscope sensors. All these sensors we actually deploy. Our mobile phone itself consists of so many different type of sensors. Okay, so next we have something called resources. So every sensor means device will have certain resources. These are nothing but the software components what we have. So using these particular resources, we can perform different operations. Like whatever the information that is gathered, we may try to perform operations on that. We may try to analyze that particular data. Everything we can perform using these resources. After that, these systems also consist of controller services. Obviously, since we are deploying so many different devices in the environment, we need to make sure that there is some mechanism using which we can control these devices. Because if we are not able to control them, what will happen? Each one will function and it will go in its own direction. But we don't want like that. We want everything in a controlled and a structured manner. So definitely we require some services related to controlling operations. Like how to control the devices. Like I told you, you know, setting the room temperature to 24, 25 degrees. So there should be some controlling mechanism is there. What is that? As soon as the temperature is below the 25 degrees, automatically the system will turn off. And if the temperature is above the 25 degrees, automatically the AC will turn on. So who is controlling? So definitely there should be some services that are related with respect to controller. And these are the ones which are actually controlling that particular devices. That is what is saying in this. Finally, we have a database. Well, we do have a local database, or we can have a cloud-based database. Okay. So local database is nothing but within your system. You people are trying to gather the data and you are keeping it for your sake. Whereas coming to cloud, what we are doing here is, we have an internet connection using which we people are directly connecting to cloud. So we are storing all the data that is gathered by this particular devices into cloud. And based on that, we are performing some operations. Fine, these are some of the devices. Apart from that, we do have other devices like something called web services. So in the previous session, we discussed about web services, right? We have two most important web services, that is REST service and WebSocket protocol. We already discussed in the previous session. REST service is nothing but a representational state transfer used to provide web service related. Means in your smartphone, you people have developed an application using which you want to control what we call the devices, the Internet of Things devices, which you people have stored in a environment. How we can access them from your smartphone using that particular web application, whatever we have created. But this web application requires a protocol, requires a API using which it can connect to that particular device. That is the service is provided by this particular web service. Okay, then we have analysis component as I stated. So we require certain components which can perform some operations, which can analyze that particular information, whatever we people are gathering. So based on that, we'll perform different operations and we try to find out how it is working or how it is functioning. Next, finally, what we have is applications. Now here coming to applications is nothing but the user related applications. We people might be developing some applications. Like in our mobile phone, we have several different kind of applications, right? Same way here with respect to the project, whatever we people are going to create, in that we will be using. Like for example, we have a weather monitoring system. right? So for that we have a website, isn't it? For weather monitoring, you want to know the today's weather. What do you people are going to do? You will open the Google Chrome. Will you be typing weather, today's weather? So it will open one particular web page. That page is what we are designing. That is what we call it as application. In the same way, that can be represented in a format of an application. That is what is saying in this particular scenario. Okay, so using this application, we can even access our data. We can even try to, what we call, measure the temperature automatically. Okay, which are directly connected to your devices, which you people have deployed in the environment. Okay, so these are the basic things. Well, this is all theoretical related. Now, first see the difference. Next, there is a small flashlight related to your REST and WebSocket based. There is a comparison. So already we have discussed these things earlier. The same thing we are actually repeating here. Something called first one is stateless versus stateful. So which one is stateless? We already discussed. REST is a stateless in nature. What does that mean? Whatever the request is sent by client to server, every request is independent of each other. Means every request should consist of information related to client. Whereas coming to WebSocket, it is a stateful. Means you don't have to send from client to server every time the details. First time a connection is going to establish. First time the client is sending a request to the server, a connection to establish. So in this, he will send the information related to server, client, to the server. Now, once this connection is established, we don't have to perform any operation. Automatically, the data will be transmitted using these particular things. Finally, at the end, what we need to do, again, the client should send a request saying to please disconnect this particular connection. And the server will respond to that particular request. This is what actually happens in this particular scenario. So that's why it is called stateful WebSocket. This is more secure. This is something like, you know, wireless. Okay. So REST is stateless, is nothing but wireless. In this way, you can understand. And stateful is nothing but wired kind of thing. So next we have unidirectional, bidirectional. Well, REST is purely unidirectional in nature. Means in one direction only you can transmit the data. And for example, from client to server. So when you're sending the data from client to server, server cannot send the data to client. So next time the server is sending data to client, and at the same time the client cannot send the data to server. Whereas coming to WebSocket, it is bidirectional, means both way communication takes place simultaneously. So both way communication can take place. So both sides arrows are there. So both sides at a time you people can try to transmit the messages. Next, request response were full duplex. So if you come across this particular REST, it is a request response model that we already discussed. This is one of the communication model which we have discussed in the previous session. So here the client will send a request, and based on that the server is going to respond. Now whereas coming to WebSockets here, it is a full duplex in nature. That is nothing but this one. So they both ways the data transmission can take place simultaneously. So that's why we call it as full duplex communication. Next we have something called as TCP connection. So what we are doing exactly in TCP here is, in this particular REST base, we are using HTTP request. Okay, using this particular HTTP, we are trying to establish a connection using TCP. Same way here also we are using TCP connection, but here we are using a full duplex mode. But in TCP here, we will be using a single mode. Okay, because it is unidirectional in nature. Next we have something called header overhead. So which one will be a burden now? Obviously the REST. The REST is a burden here. Why? Because each and every time here, the client is sending a request to the server, he has to give all the details of a client. Every request he is sending, all the details of the client has to be transmitted here. That's the overhead here. Whereas coming to WebSocket, only the first time when you are initiating the connection here. So only at that time you have to provide the information. Remaining time you can directly send the request, get the response and perform the operation. So that's why there is no overhead in WebSocket, but whereas coming to header, we do have overheads here. Next, we have something called scalability. So which one is more independent? So obviously REST is more independent because it's wireless in nature. So every request, whatever we are sending is independent. But whereas coming to WebSocket, well, it is not independent. Each and every request you people are transmitting here, those are interrelated with each other. Because all these requests, whatever you people are transmitting from client to server is not independent. okay, first time you are establishing a connection, then all the data, whatever you are transmitting, receiving it, these are not independent of each other. That's why it is somewhat difficult. Okay, cumbersome is saying nothing but somewhat complicated. But whereas coming to scalability for REST, it is much more easier. So these are some of the differences what you people can use or you can understand. Okay. So this all we have discussed individually. Here just a comparison has been provided. Okay, next come to the levels here. So we have total 6 levels. So coming to the first level, what is discussing here is in this particular, I'll show you the diagram so that you can understand easily. Now this is the level. So this particular model is what we call it as IoT level 1. So what exactly it is doing? So okay, this is a separate part. This is the device. This is what we call it as monitoring node. Okay, this monitoring node is what we call it here is device. Don't get confused. This is simple. This is separate. This is separate. He is saying that in IoT level 1, we will be having a single node. This is what we call single node. And this node is used for monitoring purpose. It is used for analyzing purpose as well as for storing the data. All the three operations are done by this particular single node itself. Got my point? So this is a single node. IoT level 1 consists of only a single node which will be performing like monitoring the information, analyzing the data, storing the data. Now this is what we call it as a device here. This is represented. Now there is a separation here. This is a local one. This is a cloud platform. If you understand perfectly, you can, with the help of a diagram, you can understand that these are purely related to local. There is no connection with cloud. You can see here. There is no connection here. It's purely local based application. So any smart devices you people are designing, any smart applications you want to design, which doesn't have a cloud connection, that all comes under IoT level 1. Okay. So in this, if you look at here, this is a device we have. What is the main purpose of this particular device is nothing but it has to perform different operations. What are the operations? That is nothing but it has to analyze the data. Since we have deployed the environment, since we have deployed everything in the environment, right? So this is a device, what we are talking about here. This device is nothing but this particular node. And this node we are deploying in the environment. And from this environment, it is trying to sense the data. Okay. And based on that data, it will be transmitting to the controller service. Now, what is controller service? So I think you can understand now. Already we have discussed this. These are the components we have. Earlier we have discussed device, resource, controller, service, REST, and finally application. So here from the device, what it is going to do, it will gather the information from the environment, send it to the resource. Resource is nothing but whatever the hardware resource provided to this support, provided to this particular device. From here, it will be transmitted to the controller service. Now, this controller service is responsible to send the information to the database as well as analyzing that particular information. Whatever the data, for example, this device is a temperature sensor. It is reading the temperature every second. That is transmitted, that is stored in the resource. From the resource, it is taken by the controller service. Now this control service will record, means it will see the data, and that data he is storing a database. Now remember, this database is a local database, not cloud based. There is no connection between local and cloud. So we are not using any cloud based application. It's purely local. Maybe your laptop, your system is having the database. You're storing all the data in your system, laptops. Okay. So this is the database. Apart from storing the information, it will be performing different operations also. It will analyze. For example, I just want to know the average temperature of today. Okay, today what is the average? Because it's very rainy as well as it's very hot today. So I just want to know what is the average temperature the whole day. So how we can get the temperature? Since the device is calculating the information, okay, one by one, okay, per second, all that values I am going to do the average. So that is the average temperature of today. Okay, that way we can identify. So from where we are getting the information means we have stored the information in database. Now what about this REST and WebSocket service? What it does? Well, the main purpose of this is it is used for retrieving the data from the database as well as updating the information to the database. Okay, how? By making use of applications. Like in your smartphone, you people have developed the application where you people wanted to access the information. right? What is the average temperature? So you people might be doing some info calculations using that application. So whatever you are updating there, that information will be brought here and updated here. So the main purpose of REST or WebSocket service is updating as well as retrieving the information from the database based upon the request sent by this particular application. This is what the whole about your level one. I'll explain this with a simple example so that you can understand easily. Let us take an example. We will take an example of your home automation here. Home automation. So what do you mean by home automation is nothing but in your home, we have several different type of lights, right? We have so many lights. I want to control those lights as well as other electronic gadgets using my smartphone. You're getting my point? I want to control my TV. I want to switch on my TV using my smartphone device. I want to switch on the lights using my mobile phone. I don't want to turn on the switch. I simply want to use a mobile phone. By clicking one button in my mobile phone, the light should turn on. By clicking on the one button, the light should turn off. Same way, with the help of my smartphone device, I want to turn on my AC. Okay, with the help of that device, I want to turn off my AC. So that is what comes home automation. Now, how it works, I'll explain it. Please listen carefully. Act as an interface at our home and other electronic things. This device will interface with those particular lights. How it is going to interface? We have relay switches. Well, this is related to what we call EC department, EEE. So relay switches are used there. This is kind of on and off kind of switches. Using this switches, this device means our sensor is going to get interacting with the light. Okay, so whenever I switch on here, so automatically the relay switch will turn on. Whenever I am switching off the mobile smartphone in my smartphone, the relay switch will turn off the light. Okay, so this is what the device we are using here. Now, what about this controller service? What it does, it will actually try to get the state of the light, whether the state means he is performing some controlling operation. What is a controlling operation? Determining whether the lights are on or off. Okay. So if it is on, I want to turn it off. If it is off, I want to turn it on. So that controlling information is done by this particular device. And finally, REST-based. So what this is going to do, he is going to deploy locally. It is deployed locally, which will allow us to retrieve and update the data. Okay, so since it is in the local, so deployed locally, and what it will do, it will try to get the data from the database, perform some operation based upon the application, and store the information in the database. This is what it is going to do. Okay, this is what the simple level one, what we have in this particular scenario. Next, we have a level two. This is somewhat advanced one. You can understand here. Yeah, see here. Coming to the level two, what you people can do, we have only a single monitoring node here, which will perform analysis. Remember, in the past, in the previous internet of level one, what we are seeing, it is monitoring. The node is going to monitor, perform analysis, store the data. But level two is not the case. In level two, we people are just monitoring the node, performing the analysis, but the data will be stored in the cloud. So this means it is a cloud-based application. You can see that there is a lot of difference between the previous slide and this slide, right? Clearly, please observe it. I'll show you the previous slide one more time so that you can understand. This is very important. That's the reason I'm making you people. See here. Application, REST or WebSocket services, database is present in 11, local. We don't have anything in cloud. But this time, after this, in level 2, what happens? This application, WebSocket, database has been transmitted to cloud. So whatever the data we people are gathering, everything will be stored in the cloud. Now this cloud is nothing but this is a cloud. Okay. So here, if we talk about here, we have controller service. So in local, what will be having? We'll have a controller service, resources, and devices. Now this device is responsible for monitoring and performing the analysis. Means analytical part, it can do it since the controller is present in local. But where we are going to store the data is nothing but we will be storing the information. Maybe the results, maybe the output, maybe the input. Everything we will be storing in this particular. So this level two is a cloud-based application. I'll explain with the example here. The example for this, what we can take is smart irrigation. Okay, so smart irrigation, what we are going to do in this is, we will try to sense the moisture level. Okay, if the moisture is very dry, we'll automatically turn on the pump. Okay, they'll start sprinkling the water. If the soil moisture level is wet, we'll automatically turn off that particular pump. Okay. So this is what we call as smart irrigation. Now in this, with the example, what the sensor node is going to do is, it will try to mark this particular sensor node, that's nothing but this device. Is what is the main responsibility of the device here is, it has to gather the moisture level. It has to monitor the moisture level and control the irrigation system. Irrigation system is nothing but that sprinkling the water, turning off the sprinkling of water, that should be controlled by this particular device. Okay, after that we have controllers here. Okay, what is the main purpose of controller? Already we discussed. Now in this scenario, it is going to continuously monitor the moisture level. Okay, so controller will be continuously monitor the moisture level, and based upon that, it is going to store the information in the database, as well as it will take action. Means the controller will provide, it will come to know, it will analyze based upon the data received from the database that the moisture is very low. So it will signal the device, turn on that pump. So the device will start turning on the pump and the water will be sprinkled. So after some time, when this device is going to send the data will be stored here with the help of control service. It will analyze it again after some time. Now, based upon that, it will come to know, now the moisture is very much wet. Stop sprinkling the water. It will again send a command to the device asking to stop sprinkling. So automatically it will be turned off. This is the scenario how it works. And what about this? So we can use our smartphone, since we have designed what we call application. So using that application will come to know whether we are sprinkling the water, we are switching off the water and all. So those things comes under this. I'll show you a small practical example later after the completion of this level, how you people can see what do you mean by application, how we are turning it on and off, that I'll show you. Okay, so don't worry. So this, just understand this particular concept. So it is purely cloud-based application where the sensing and monitoring is done in the local level, but whereas coming to the analyzing the information and storing the information, everything will be done in this particular cloud platform. Okay, fine. So next we have level 3. Level 3 is similar to that. You can see the difference here. In level 3, you can see the top part is same, but look at the difference here. Earlier diagram, we have in level 2, we have a node which is monitoring, performing analysis, but data is stored in cloud. But if you are coming to level 3, what happens? The node is responsible only to monitor the information. That's it. He is not responsible for analyzing, means and send it to the cloud. Within the cloud, we will be performing something called analysis as well as storing. Okay, so upper portion is same. So here, this device is responsible for gathering the data. That's it. So using the data will be transmitted to the database here, cloud. So this is a cloud-based application. So within the cloud, we are storing the information. From this information, we are going to analyze it, okay, with the help of a controller. This controller will try to get the data from here, analyze the data. Based on that, it will give action to this particular device. Same way, using this particular app, we can try to get the information, whether it is sprinkling or not sprinkling or not. So all these things comes under level 3. It's very easy. Only variation what you people can see is in the bottom part. Okay, I'll show you one more time. Here the level 2, we have monitoring node, performance analysis. Then it is followed with cloud storage. But in the next one, level 3, see, the analysis part is not here. That analysis part has been shifted to cloud. So here the device is, this device is responsible to gather the information, send it to the control service, he will send the data to database. So when sufficient database is collected, it will try to gather the data from this particular database, perform the analysis, based on that it will give information to this. So all this is done in cloud. And application, using the application, we can try to access. So therefore, there should be a net connection for this particular device. Okay, so next we have something called as level 4. Well, as we are progressing now, the data in this level, you people can see somewhat complications are coming up here. There is no complications actually, just independent data nodes we are adding. Look at here in level 4, we have only a single node, single monitoring node, but right now we have two nodes. So what is the main purpose of this particular node here is nothing but monitoring, performing local analysis. Means in this level 4 we will be performing monitoring as well as analysis will be done in this particular local level, this local level, but the data will be stored in the cloud. Okay, this is entirely separate. This is a normal representation, inbuilt representation is this. And here the device, whatever you are seeing, is nothing but this particular node. So this particular node will have resources controller, so that is what represented here. Okay, so if you look at here, so monitoring and analysis will be done locally here and the information will be stored in the cloud. So since we have multiple nodes here, same way we have multiple devices, so every device will have its own resources, they'll have own controller service to control the information, and based on that it will transmit the data to the database which is present in the cloud. But if you observe here, he is not going to use WebSocket. Remember, IoT level 4 will focus only on REST services, means this is wireless. Okay, so there is a possibility that each and every request what we are sending here is independent. It uses REST based application. It doesn't use something called as WebSocket. Previous diagrams we have WebSocket, means they can use either REST or WebSocket. But IoT level 4 can use only REST services. It will not use WebSocket. And this is the component where we will be analyzing the data. So whatever the data is gathered by this particular node, we are storing in cloud. So that will be analyzed using this particular component. And based on that, this particular will be transmitted to the application, whatever we have designed and associated. Remember, there is one observer node in cloud and local. This is something new right now. Now, what is the main purpose of observer is nothing but making sure everything is functioning properly. Means this observer node will actually try to analyze this portion, analyzing it, how the system is working, everything will be taken care by this. Remember, these observer nodes are not going to control them. They are only meant to observe. That's why these are called observers. They'll just like come and observe the information. They will not interfere with any of these particular services. Like controller, resource, they will not interfere. They'll simply try to observe the information, how it is functioning. Whether every controller service is working fine or not, resources are working fine or not, devices are functioning fine or not, that will be taken care by this observer node. And there will be one in the local and there will be another in the observer. Okay. Next. Let me just raise it up. Finally, we have level 5 here. So coming to level 5, this is much more complicated. The best example for level 5, what we can see here is noise. Okay, noise monitoring, you wanted to do it. Now, if you observe here, level 5, we people have multiple independent nodes. Remember here, we don't have two nodes. Here simply represented two, but we have multiple independent nodes here. These nodes are independent of each other. And these are different type of nodes. Indirectly, what it means to say is, each one is a separate sensor. These sensors actually gather the information, transmit it to the coordinator. There will be a coordinator here who will be making, this is something like you people, these are the class students. And this is the class representative, and here is the class teacher. Now the class coordinator will coordinate with these students, get the information from them, translate the information to, like for example, I gave some assignment to you people. I want to know how many of you completed. So the coordinator will actually coordinate with the student. So how many students we have? Multiple students are there. There are no two students, right? Multiple students of different characters, okay? Different behavior, okay? Different attitudes. So it will try to gather the information from this and it will be transmitted to me. So finally, the coordinator is going to send a message to me. So these many students completed. These are saying we need time, or these are saying something. So that is what represented. Okay, it's clear. So here in level 5, we'll be having multiple different end nodes. Those are connected to the coordinator and using which we are transmitting the data. So the coordinator will collect the data and transmit it to the cloud. Remember, he is only sending the data, whereas coming to analysis and storage is done in this particular cloud. The arrow is the diagram related to that. So we have multiple different devices. Every device will have its own resources and it will have its own controller services. Now they will perform the operations, but these can communicate with each other. These devices can communicate with each other. So that's what been represented here. You can see here the arrows. So this controller service can interact with this particular. So this controller service is able to interact with them. So based on that, they will gather the information and store that in the database. From the database, this particular analytical component will be try to analyze the data, and based on that, it will predict it, whether the noise is very high or noise is very low and all. So based on that, the information will be transmitted to the application. What application? This is a smartphone application, what we have. So when you open it up, it will tell you, so this much air pollution is there, this much noise pollution is there. So that information is transmitted by this. How it is transmitting? Using either REST or WebSocket based service. But first it will analyze the information present in the data. It is purely mathematical. So based on that, it is transmitting data. So like in the previous levels, we have here two observers. These observers will try to gather the information. Just see whether all these are functioning properly or not. And based on that, make sure everything's working fine. If not working properly, it will intimate to these devices so that they can try to overcome that particular problem. So this is also a cloud-based application. Now the example for this, what we can take is your noise monitoring sensor. Already I told you. So in noise monitoring, we'll be having multiple different type of sensor nodes. Okay, so these nodes will be independent of each other and they will be trying to gather the information and store it into the cloud database. And same way the analysis part will be done. Next, the last one is level 6. Well, this is the one which we use it for our weather monitoring system. So if anyone is interested in developing a project related to your weather monitoring system, then you people have to implement this level. If you are able to implement this IoT level, then only we can implement the web service. So if you look at here, come to the bottom part here, first we'll look at this. So we have multiple monitoring nodes here. So we don't have a coordinator. In the previous level 5, we have a coordinator. But right now we are having here a centralized controller. He is the one who will control all the information. But it will store the information in the cloud where the analysis part and the storage part is done. Okay. The centralized coordinator is controller, is responsible for getting the data from all this. And based on that, it will perform some controlling operations and send the data to cloud. And in the cloud, we will be analyzing. So whatever the applications we are designing, that will be performing analysis on the data received in the cloud. And based on that, it will be displayed on your application, whatever we are using. Okay. Many of your smartphones might be having AccuWeather. You will be having a weather, what we call app. Okay. When you open it up, you can see this. When you open it up in the first page in your smartphone, you will get a weather temperature small icon. In that, it will say something like Vishakhapatnam 26 degrees centigrade moderate rain, right? How it is able to display that? How we are getting, how this app is getting the data? It is getting the data from this particular database. How the system is saying that it is 26 degrees based upon the data stored in this. This is analyzing the data and based on that, it is sending you the information that it is 26 degrees centigrade or 26 degrees Fahrenheit, whatever it might be. Okay. So here coming to level 6, this is used for weather monitoring. Remaining process is same, nothing much different. We'll have a single observer, small slight variation, that's it. We have a centralized controller here. In level 5, we have a coordinator. So based on that, we are performing it. So since we have multiple devices, the multiple devices will have multiple resources will have multiple control service and they will transmit the data to the centralized controller here. This is the centralized controller represented here. And using this, we'll be transmitting information to REST by WebSocket based interface. And from here, the remaining process takes place. The best example for this is your forest fire detection. That is in level 5. And whereas coming to level 6, we people can use weather monitoring system. Means level 5, whatever we discussed, we can use for forest detection. Like in the previous in Australia, there was a very huge fire, right? So using this IoT device, we can try to predict earlier that there is going to be a such a fire accident, and we can try to avoid it. Same way, coming to weather monitoring system, and so we can use this level, IoT level 6. So here, this level will be useful in order to determine what will be the temperature, and based on that, what precautions need to be taken, like whether a cyclone is coming or not and all. Based on that, it will analyze it and it will tell. I think most of you might have known it in our news channels. They say, recently when for 2 or 4 years back, when Hudhud came to Vishakhapatnam, they said that from past 90 years or past 10 years, past 50 years, after 50 years, such a kind of cyclone came for Vishakhapatnam. How these people are able to predict that after 50 years it came? So that information is actually stored in this database. So they analyzed it. Based on that, they have given information. Not only that, even they might have predicted earlier that if Hudhud strikes Vishakhapatnam fully, then entire Vishakhapatnam will be going off. How they are saying it? So they are based upon the data received from the previous cyclone. They have analyzed it, and based on that, they are providing the information to you people. So this way, IoT plays a very important role, and these are the levels using which we people can design different software, or different applications which are useful for our daily life. Okay, so these are some of the levels what we have in your IoT. So thank you for watching. So in the next session, we're discussing about the next part of your unit. Let me